Yes, my name is Ruben Ntuluki, the chairman of the Carbon Environmental Awareness Society. You know, the Carbon Environmental Awareness Society will this year be presenting to you Carbon Walk 2015. It will be beginning from Kasani to Gaborone as a 1,000-kilometer walk. Already we have done 310 kilometers from Kasani to Nata, and currently we are at Nata Lodge where we are camping as we do our night vigil to start from our rest as we are doing a cleanup campaign today in Nata and this morning. Tomorrow we're doing Duki Refugee Camp. That's where we're going to camp for the next 70 kilometers from here, and possibly do the last 110 kilometers on the second day to reach Francistown as we keep doing our environmental education by engaging the public to say the solution of climate change and environmental degradation is within ourselves, each and every one of us. We need to change our ways, how we relate with the environment, and we're doing this with a holistic approach of engaging people in environmental education as we conserve the environment at the same time. You know, it's difficult to stop an ordinary man out there on the street to say, hey, let's talk about an environmental climate conservation and so forth. And, you know, I thought maybe walking a 1,000 kilometer, it would have raised eyebrows, and one would have asked themselves back at home to say, why would someone want to be so crazy or so insane that they would walk a 1,000 kilometer? And not just only that, through a park, national park, that's filled with wild animals, ranging from buffaloes to elephants and your elands, your lions, your baboons, you know, yeah. All sorts of kinds you can name of. But, you know, just getting to say, at least if someone out there can hear the voice of climate change and feel the heat that's coming with the pressure that we have put upon ourselves by, you know, working or acting carelessly with our environment on a day-to-day activities. Yeah, we started off in Kasani with a massive cleanup campaign that started off as a very sad moment for me personally as an environmentalist. You know, I had gone to just maybe get a breather of some air at the Chobe River, and to my surprise, when I got there, I found a lot of trash of litter ranging from, you know, diapers to latex condoms to, you know, papers, plastics to tins to bottles, all kinds of things you can think of on the riverfront. And to me, that was an environment crying and say, help, I need help. And immediately we seeked help from the relevant authorities. We engaged in a cleanup campaign, okay, without wasting any time. I would like to extend my gratitude to the likes of Chobe Marina, you know, Lodge, for extending their hand through the cleanup campaign of the Chobe River by offering their boats to clean the shores also, and offering their staff make time out of their busy schedule, and also offer hand in helping us clean the river shores and the river fronts as we moved along the river and engaged other stakeholders like your SPA, Kasani, Chopis, and your land board. We tried, you know, the wildlife. You know, funny for me to explain, you know, it was more of also a training that was being offered, free training, free military training. We are being offered by the anti-poaching unit. You know, they helped us understand, you know, the ground and the wildlife behaviors to say, when we encounter such behaviors, how do you do when you get to the campsites? What's the first thing you do? And also their presence on the road also helped us, you know, control the traffic. The truck drivers, they're not very polite out there. And, you know, we needed the APU unit to be available to come handy for us. And, you know, they really helped us to really cover this 310 kilometers you know, I didn't know my body could do so many kilometers within a couple of hours. You know, 14 hours, we could be doing 15 hours sometimes. But bottom line was, you know, they were always there in the presence and making sure that everything is done in precautions, waking us as early as 3 o'clock in the morning. We find water is ready, you know, food is also good to go. And these guys just want to get us on the road and get us going. And for that, we are very thankful. But let me also add one thing that, you know, as I moved along the way, I saw the need, you know, to get to engage more and more stakeholders in this initiative, because as we moved along all the way, the 310 kilometers along the way, it showed that, you know, there's a lot of debt out in the national park, and it's not looking good out there for us. It could be poison that's going to go to our wildlife, and if anti-poaching is doing their best to conserve this wildlife, and they're going to end up dying because of the waste that's been thrown into the park by people who pass through the park with their trucks and so forth, doing oil spillage, you know, exchanging oils wherever they stop by. You know, a lot of authorities need to be jump on board. Yeah, maybe just to add into a wrap, I'll say, you know, Climate Change Summit is coming up in France, COP21 in Paris. And I'm hoping for a lot of decisions to be made towards initiatives as such as ourselves to be empowered from, you know, most particularly the people who contribute significantly to the effects that we find ourselves in this climate change. You know, your oil industry needs to really push funds into initiatives to also to be seen as solution providers to the line of business challenging that they are providing to the environment. And in that way, I think collectively we'll help safeguard our planet Earth. You